breakfast. That means you give nutrients to your body. That means you have nourished your body by providing food to your cells in your body. Today we are going to learn about the lesson nutrition. Nutrition means we are providing food or obtaining food for the health and growth to our body. Nutrition means we are providing food to our body for our health and growth or repairing the cells in our body. Next, the nutrition is of different types. First one is autotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic means nutrition for nourishment. Plants are the autotrophs. Why we call as autotrophs to plants? Because they prepare their own food. They acquire nutrients from the soil and water. Next, they acquire carbon dioxide from air and they prepare carbohydrates, lipids, proteins in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. Okay, that's why we call as plants autotrophs. This process is also known as photosynthesis. You have already studied about this photosynthesis in your 8th and 9th classes. Next, here the plants are providing food to our all organisms on the earth. So that's why we call them universal food providers, because all the organisms, including human beings, animals, and all organisms depend upon plants. That's why we can say that plants are the universal food providers. Next one is heterotrophic nutrition. Here, the hetero, the word is derived from Greek language. Hetero means other. These organisms means primary, secondary, and tertiary consumers. That means all animals depend upon plants for their food. They are not capable of preparing their own food. They are not capable of synthesizing food. So that's why they are called as heterotrophs. But the autotrophs have the capability of preparing food. That's why they are called as autotrophs. Auto means nutrition. They are providing nutrition to us. That's why they are called as universal food providers. But the heterotrophs are not preparing their food. They are depending upon the autotrophs or plants. So that's why they are called as heterotrophs. Here, primary consumers, secondary consumers, and tertiary consumers are called as heterotrophs. What are the primary and secondary and tertiary consumers? The herbivores, for primary. Next type of nutrition is called as supplement. Before that, for example, we see grass means produces. Next, this grass is eaten by rabbit, and rabbit is eaten by fox. Next, fox is eaten by wolf. Okay, I think you have understood that. Saprophytic nutrition is nothing but, we can say examples, bread mold, yeast and mushrooms. What is it meant by? Means here the organisms do not have the digestive system. They release enzymes on food materials, rotten food materials, and they acquire the nutrients from that food materials and they lead their life. So this type of nutrition is called as saprophytic nutrition. These organisms are called as saprophyte. Saprophytes, example, bread molds, yeast, mushrooms. You can see mushrooms on gardens. They grow just like umbrella, white color. I think you observed in your areas. These mushrooms also acquire the nutrients from the rotten materials. Not they take the food. They release some enzymes and they acquire nutrients. Example, bread mold also. You can see it in your home. So the brown, not ash color growth on the bread. These organisms are called as bread mold. So these are called as rhizophores. So this organisms release enzyme on the food. They acquire the nutrients and they live their life. This type of nutrition is called as saprophytic nutrition. Next, parasitic nutrition. Parasitic nutrition means here the organisms do not acquire prepare their food. They depend upon others for their food. They absorb food from the organisms. Examples, flies, leeches, and tapeworms, and Cascuda plants. Here, the organisms, they grow on the body of the animals or inside of the animal's bones. Example, lice on your head. Next, leeches. Leeches suck blood from your legs and on the animal body also we can see leeches. Next, tapeworms. Some tapeworms grow in stomach. They acquire the food from your stomach. Next, Cascuda plant. This plant grow on other plants. They penetrate root-like structures into the other plant and acquire nutrients. That's why they are called as parasites. So they depend upon other plants and other organisms for their food. So that's why they are called as what? Parasites. This type of nutrition is called as parasitic nutrition. Let us discuss about the photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the process by which plants build up complex organic molecules from simple inorganic molecules. That means here the complex organic molecules are the carbohydrates, lipids and proteins. Simple inorganic molecules are the minerals, water, carbon dioxide. That means plants are preparing the organic complex molecules from simple inorganic molecules, and they release oxygen as a waste product, and several reactions also takes place in this process. Some intermediate compounds are also formed. And the end products are the glucose, water and oxygen. Here the main product is glucose and waste products are water. unification is proposed by C.P. Van Niel in 1931. CO2 plus 2H2O gives rise CH2O plus H2O plus oxygen or O2 in presence of white and chlorophyll. This equation is proposed by C.P. Van Niel. Here the inorganic compounds are carbon dioxide and water. Next, organic compounds, complex compounds are CH2O. And here the end products are these. In this complex compound is CH2O. Next, he worked on purple sulfur bacteria. Okay, and found the light plays an important role in photosynthesis. Instead of H2O, he used H2S in his photosynthesis process on purple sulfur bacteria. And again, in this process, instead of oxygen, sulfur gas is liberated. Okay, so here the equation is CO2 plus 2H2O gives rise CH2O. That means the short form of glucose proposed by the C.P. Van Niel. But later, now we are using divided reaction. That is nothing but here we can change like this. C6H12O6. C6H12O6. Here 6CO2 and here 12H2O gives rise C6H12O6 and 6H2O 6O2. Now we are using this equation. So this is now later proposed by different scientists. Okay. This equation is proposed by Robert Hill. Finally, this equation is proposed by Robert Hill. 6CO2 plus H2O gives rise C6H12O6. 6H2O plus 6O2 is proposed by Robert Hill. Okay, later in next class we will discuss about presence of starch in leaves. Okay, today I am going to give you some homework. So, autotrophic nutrition, heterotrophic nutrition, saprophytic and parasitic nutrition, you have to write the definitions and the examples. Okay.